So you have some raw images and you want to turn them into a professional looking poster design, something that a pro team would use on social media? Well, this is the sports design tutorial for you. You can download the assets and walk through step by step with me, or you can use your own images and create a very, very similar design. The first step is to drag a rectangle across half of your screen. Next, we're going to hit the fill button and then change it to whatever color we want. Now, place an image of a stadium or any background item of your choosing, and we're going to change the blend mode to pin light. You can delete the other half of the stadium. We won't need any of that. You can do this by raster sizing your layer and then pressing delete. All right, this is when the design really starts. So let's insert our first player layer. And remember, you can use your own player images and customize the design however you want. Set this player image to the blend mode color burn. Now this is where the important stuff really comes into play. Drag your first image of a logo into the design. Next, click the effects button and then click drop shadow. Copy these exact settings. I use these settings for every single image that I put into this specific design so that it looks like it's layered on top of each other. This is what it looks like without the drop shadow, and this is what it looks like after. Let's throw our next two player images into the design. We are looking to create this sharpen look like you see on the right side of your screen. Let's go up to filter, sharpen, and then hit unsharp mask. For me, I just increase the amount and a little bit of the threshold. This creates a clear cut photo. You can see the before and then the after. But this is just the first step in the sharpening process. The second step is to go up to filter and then camera raw filter. Let's increase the clarity, which will darken our image slightly, and we'll also add some contrast. Decrease the blacks and then add back on some vibrance. This gives you a good looking player image, a little bit better, but not quite where we want to be at. But let's definitely trust the process here. All right, let's head back into camera raw filter. Decrease our blacks, crank up contrast as well as texture. And the most important part, and I can't emphasize this enough, is to reduce the yellows in your image. This gives you a much better looking overall player image, but we're not quite done yet. For the second photo, I'm going to also reduce the yellows a little bit and make some other adjustments and then hit OK. We aren't quite done yet with this side of our graphic, but let's get started on the second side. Drag a rectangle across the background of your image, change it to whatever color you want, and put a player image and stretch it across the entire background. Go up to adjustments and then change it to black and white. We're then going to switch the blend mode to hard light. Reduce the opacity so that your player looks like it's almost faded in the background. Now let's add some stripes to our background image. Create one rectangle and drag it across your image. Remember that these rectangles should be placed above your image of the player's face of the faded background. If you press Command J, you then can duplicate your rectangles. Change the rectangle color from black to your team's logo color. Next, insert your team's logo and cut it down the halfway marker of the design. We're going to change the blend mode to multiply, decrease the opacity on the logo so it has the same faded look that we have for the player image in the background. Insert a logo, two player images, and any other image that you want to have inside this design. Remember to apply that drop shadow that we talked about earlier, because it makes it look like everything is stacked on top of each other. A lot of your graphic designs have these player images that look like this. Let me show you how to add some detail and some pop to them. It is important that you look at these adjustments that I'm making, but you gotta understand that every design is gonna be different. So here's what we started out with, and here's what we have now. Next, I'm going to drop in my 3D text. If you guys want text like this or my textures, overlays, as well as stickers, check out my Patreon. I have a bunch of helpful stuff over there, including PSDs to my recent videos, as well as some of my templates of my favorite designs. The link is going to be in the description below, so please feel free to check that out. All right, let's get back to the design. Let's create a new layer at the very top of our layer panel. Next, hold down Shift, Alt, and Command E. Open up Camera Raw Filter and make the following adjustments. One of the best additions to this entire design is this preset within Camera Raw Filter. It's called PMO2. Essentially, what it does is it darkens the outside of your design. If you look at the colors of the players, they're not going to really match at all. So one trick that I will use in most of my designs is to put on color lookups. For me personally, I like to use 3-strip to add a red tint to my designs. And then I choose a Fuji filter that looks good for the graphic and it fits well. If you're looking for a true movie poster look, throw on the filter Kodak 2395. If the color lookups are at all too strong for you, you can always reduce the opacity. For this design, I decided to bring out some of the colors that were lost within these filters, so I increased the vibrance as well as the hue and saturation. Also, I love to put gradient maps on my designs, so I chose the two main colors and then I put them into a gradient map. Change the blend mode to hue and then reduce the opacity. I personally like the design without the color lookups, but if you're looking for a true movie poster design, this is the way to go. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Thanks for checking out the channel. If you want to see more videos like this, check out my recent design breakdown video right here.